In the latest macOS beta, we're getting our first look at Apple Intelligence. In this video, I'm going to give you a first look at some of the features coming on macOS Sequoia, like summarizing Safari articles, using the writing tools to proofread or reword all of your text in any app. Siri has better conversational awareness. Get transcriptions in your Apple Notes, Apple Intelligence in focus modes, and more. Plus, I missed a few features in my iOS 18.1 Apple Intelligence video, so I'm going to put them here. And keep in mind, this is the macOS Sequoia 15.1 developer beta. This is not available for the public beta, and Apple Intelligence is US only and US English only for right now. Number one, you're going to be able to get a summary of any article that you read in Safari. These are different than the summaries you'll get with the built-in Safari feature. To access Apple Intelligence summaries, you can go into reader mode, and then once the article loads, you'll see a summarize option right here. Click that, and this will summarize any article on any website, and you get a one paragraph summary right there. This will also work on sites like the New York Times. Just go into reader mode, you'll see that summarize option. Click that, and you'll get a one paragraph summary right here. And speaking of summaries, this video is brought to you by one of my new favorite apps, Headway. Headway is an awesome app for iPhone and iPad that gives you bite-sized summaries in about 15 minutes of the best nonfiction books available, both as text and audio recorded from professional voice actors. Now, I do read a lot of ebooks and physical books, but there's just so many that I wish I could fit into my day, and Headway makes that possible. I can listen to a 15-minute summary of a book just like it's a podcast, or I can jump into the text version, then I can read the text as I'm listening to the narration. Text controls are up here, and I can even go into a chapter mode and jump to other key points in the book. And one of my favorite features of Headway is this ability to remember key points or quotes from a book. I'll tap Remember here, and I can see all the key points and highlights that I've bookmarked across all the different books I've listened to. For instance, here's the Atomic Habits book, and these are some cards that I've saved as I was listening to that summary. I can even share this little snippet to my share sheet, social media, or text it to someone. And as you use Headway, you'll actually get personal recommendations based on the books that you enjoyed listening to. I can jump into a category that it knows I'm interested in, choose a new book, and I can listen to that 15-minute summary right here in the app. I can also bookmark a book and save it for later. You can even use Headway AI to ask for books on specific topics like emotional intelligence. Honestly, I love this format. It also feels kind of like a podcast, which I listen to all the time anyway. You can get Headway right now in the App Store. Just go to beard.fm/headway. It's helped me get to a lot of books that I've wanted to know what the key points are, what are they about, and some books that now I want to buy and read the whole thing. Again, you can try Headway today by going to beard.fm/headway. I did the Atomic Habits and the Subtle Art of Not Giving a, well, you know the expletive. Anyway, let me know what books you've enjoyed in Headway down in the comments, and let's get back to Apple Intelligence in macOS Sequoia. So not only do we get summaries for any Safari web page, but you can get those email summaries right here in macOS Mail. At the top of every email, you'll see a summarize button. I can click that, and it'll show me a quick summary of everything that's in the email. It's also helpful if you get a lot of brand emails or deals, and you just kind of want to see what's the sale. Just give me how much off. Well, you can see it right there in the summary. In addition to email and web summaries, you can also get text summaries in the notifications, both on your Mac and your iPhone. When you get a text message that's been summarized, you'll see this little symbol underneath the sender's name and a shortened version of the text message. You can click Show More, and then it will display the whole message. Siri is also getting a lot of improvements here in macOS Sequoia, although many of them are not available just yet. You can activate the new Siri with a double click of the command button or program that to whatever you'd like. But Siri does have contextual awareness within the conversation. So I can ask it what the weather's going to be like tomorrow in Tampa. I can have a follow-up question like, what will the humidity be? And it will tell me still from the same location and date that I asked previously. You can also ask it things like, what movie did Michael Fassbender and Kevin Bacon star in together? And again, because this is a beta, it's not getting the whole Fassbender part, but you can still ask it questions like that. And like I showed in my iOS 18.1 Apple Intelligence video, which you can check out above, or the links in the description, writing tools are available across macOS Sequoia. So even if I'm sending a text message here, I can select the text, go down to Writing Tools, and then Show Writing Tools. Now this window pops up, and I can ask it to proofread the text. It'll show me punctuation changes needed, and I can accept them just by pressing Done, or Revert using this arrow or the Revert key here. I'll click Done, accept those changes, and I can select it again, Show Writing Tools, and let's just pull the key points from this text message. If I do that, I can get some bullet points here, replace the text or copy to the clipboard, or maybe I just want to make this more concise. I can just choose that from the contextual menu, and it will make a shorter version of what I wrote. I can also use those tools in Apple Notes and third-party apps once they start supporting it, but I'll two-finger click here, Show Writing Tools. Now I can proofread, make it more friendly, concise, And this is actually a full video transcript I have, so let's get a summary of this entire transcript. And there's the summary. I can replace or copy it to my clipboard. Let's right-click it again, and maybe we want to rewrite this to be more professional. I can click rewrite here, and now it's rewritten it just for clarity. I can revert back, or I can rewrite it as friendly, professional, and other options. I'll go with friendly, and now we have a friendly rewrite of the script. Another great feature here in Apple Notes, and this will be on iOS and iPadOS as well, is you can do voice recordings with transcripts. So I can click the voice recording option here. I'll start recording, and now Apple Notes is just recording from the built-in microphone. I'm going to have this as an audio file where I can play back and listen to it, but I'll also have a transcript that I can read, copy, and use Apple Intelligence maybe to rewrite that if I'd like to. This is great for lectures or maybe other things you're recording. I'll hit done. So now it'll stop recording. I can hit play, and you can see it actually automatically has that transcript right there. I can see a summary of the transcript. Again, great for a lecture style recording, and all of that is built right into Notes. You can also record calls from your iPhone and get that transcript there as well. And both on iOS and on macOS Sequoia with Apple Intelligence, if you have focus mode set up, and I highly recommend you do it, I love my focus modes, there's now an intelligent breakthrough and silencing option. If I toggle this on, that means important notifications that Apple Intelligence thinks I should know now, it will break through that specific focus mode. You can toggle that on or off for each focus mode, and there's a new reduce interruptions focus mode that has that built in, and then you can add people, apps, schedules, and other filters specifically for this. Those settings are also available if you're on the iOS 18.1 beta with Apple Intelligence. I can go to the focus settings, go to any individual focus, and then I can toggle on intelligent breakthrough and silencing for each focus mode. For instance, for my evening focus mode, which is during weekdays after work in the evening, I've actually toggled that on to see what notifications will break through. Also, because I didn't show it in my other video, that summarization in Safari also is here on the iPhone and the iPad. If I go into reader mode here in Safari for any article, you'll see that summarized with Apple Intelligence right here. Again, this is different than the built-in summaries that are going to be coming to macOS Sequoia, regardless of whether you have Apple Intelligence or not. And there's the summary for that article, and I can do that on any web page. Also, you'll see here on iPhone, you get those summaries via text messages there, and it will also be here on your lock screen with that little summarized symbol. And Apple Intelligence is also going to do a ton of work with your photos. Right now, you can actually do custom searches like photos of Whitney with a flute. That's my wife, and she plays flute. And it'll use facial recognition to pull up my wife and when she's holding a flute. So both facial and object recognition. You'll also be able to create memory movies with Apple Intelligence, but it's still processing my photos, so I can't do that right now. Which is a great reason why you should subscribe to the YouTube channel right now, because as these Apple Intelligence features are available on all the devices, I'm going to cover them right here. Yes, I installed the betas on my main devices just for you. If you want to see Apple Intelligence specifically on the iPhone with 18.1, you can check out my video here, where I go through all of those writing tools, summaries, and more features just for the iPhone. I have my top 10 features coming to iOS 18 to everyone this fall. You can check out that video right up here. If you have any questions or features that you've discovered in Apple Intelligence, leave comments below this video, hit that like button, subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.